Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Q1 What's New with Our Product Update from Gigya. Joining me today is Adrian Nash, Vice President of our products, and I am Ratul Shah, Senior Product Marketing Manager here at Gigya. We are very excited to have all of you join us today. And we're really excited to share what we have to talk about. This is going to be a very exciting webinar as we're going to be highlighting previous quarter key functionality. We're going to demo some of those items as well. And then we're going to take some time for questions and do a brief look ahead as well into what's coming. But before we get started about talking about what we did in Q1, I'd like to recap a little bit about what happened in 2017 and what we did as a team. And by a team, I mean not just Gigya, but our customers as well. You guys are a very important part of what we develop, how we go to market, how we work, and why we're here. And we really want to give you guys a really big round of applause for all of the help you had in paving a way with our innovation. And part of that goes to directly to our client advisory board. So we invited you to come in and work with us and give us feedback and understand our roadmaps and help pave the way forward in those two client advisory boards. That was a really big thank you to you. We took that information and we used those into biweekly meetings or product committee meetings where the teams met cross-functionally to talk about what we were working on, what was working, what we needed to make better across all teams when it comes to the product, the messaging, and how we interact. And as our teams continue to get better and deliver, we delivered over 44 features last year, which is pretty monumental. And we were very excited to bring those to market to make your lives and your customers' lives even better. And as we think about our you guys and what we brought to the market, well, we had almost 1,100 unique go-lives last year, which means we helped you bring up 1,100 new websites or applications to go live, which is an amazing accomplishment. And as you think about what those go-lives entail and how long those take, that's a really big accomplishment to both our global services organization as well as you in your preparedness to go live and bring up those services. And in addition, as we think about some of the complexities that you bring to market, we have scaled our solution, our APIs, as well as how we integrate first-party data throughout the ecosystem. And that's why that number is right in the middle, those 200-plus identity sync jobs. So as you think about using first-party data throughout your ecosystem, know that some of the customers on this phone are pushing the limits of how they integrate that data throughout their ecosystem. And that's really exciting to think about. And as we look at the year in review and the features that we've brought to market, it's really exciting to think about what we've done quarter over quarter. And some of the big things that we wanted to highlight here are we brought light registration to market. This was a great piece of functionality that we were able to introduce, which helps you start the value exchange with your customers earlier in the cycle. You're able to entice them with newsletters and wish list signups to get them to give you just a little bit of information to start that journey earlier in the process. And then as you think about your own teams and how your teams work, we rolled out scope data access in Q3. This was a really important piece as you think about our console and how many different agents use that to access identity data. That's what the interesting piece is. Now you're able to limit who has access to that data. So if a call center agent only needs to work on a certain piece of the data pool, or developers only need to have subsets of that data, the administrators of the system can now limit that information, reducing your risk while still driving innovation forward. And of course, as all of you know, we went to market last year in early September with the solution we're calling Enterprise Preference Manager, and that came to market in November. And that really is instrumental in terms of your feedback to us as well as our development organization in bringing that feature, that product to market, because it is instrumental in how we support global regulations like GDPR, but it's also instrumental in how we honor our customers' trust and push forward with transparency and enable them with control of that information. it's essential, if you think about it, that transparency of their data as well as control over their data that you have about them is what's driving those regulations forward. And so we had a pretty impressive year, and I just wanted to take that moment to summarize that for you. And as we think about how Gigya develops features and what we're doing, there's a lot of trends that are happening. And as we think about what those trends are, this is what helps us drive forward with our development cycle. So as we think about it, over 63% of the customers that we've spoken with in the companies that you are looking for better customer experiences. It's really, that is what's becoming the driving factor, the unique differentiator, the unique value proposition that our customers want. We are looking as consumers that is the unique differentiator versus price and product. And as we think about how we differentiate ourselves and what will separate us, those unique experiences, those exceptional customer experience points are what is going to help differentiate you, differentiate your experiences, and drive your businesses forward against your competitors. And as you think about how the changing regulations have happened, and as you think about the markets, we're seeing with our research and the feedback that you've given us that customers are having a challenge with how they trust brands with their personal information. We've seen recent regulations such as GDPR, lots of news headlines that are all talking about these trends. And that's what Gigya's Enterprise Preference Manager, now known as SAP Hybris Consent, is really about putting that trust back in with your brands because you're able to enable transparency and control of that data. And that's our goal here at Gigya. We really want to help you turn unknown visitors into known loyal customers. And a known loyal customer is one that sticks with you, has a wonderful experience, has a great lifetime relationship, but it's also about making sure that that relationship is built on transparency and control. Because at the end of the day, those trusted relationships are the ones that are going to move through the cycle and become advocates for our businesses. And as we think about that mission, and as we think about customer experience, and we think about privacy and compliance, and enterprise agility and scale, these are the fundamental pillars that we as a product team, development, product managers, R&D, product marketing, that's how we look at every feature that we would like to bring to market. We understand that every feature that we bring to market is critical, and having that lens, having the ability to make sure that every feature is enhancing the customer journey, providing a great customer experience, that it's being developed in a way that pushes forward the privacy and compliance aspects of our businesses, but doing it in a secure way. And then as we develop those features, making sure that they're scalable and that they push forward with enterprise agility, as we think about your businesses and how fast that you need to bring features to market and bring innovations in terms of customer experience to your clients. And as your brands are in multiple regions and geographies and built on web technologies, we need to take all of those things into consideration to make it easier for you to get up and running with our technology. And as we talk about it, we put all of those innovations into those solutions from Gigya. And these are the ways we go to market. We have three products that we go to market with. SAP Hybris Identity. This is the way that we help you engage with your customers across channels and devices. This is that way to reduce friction at the point of registration and start that relationship. SAP Hybris Consent is part and parcel core to how trusted relationships are built, because this is what enables the ability to build it on trust and transparency and ultimately give them control as part of that. And then SAP Hybris Profile. This helps power all of those digital experiences. As we saw in that original slide where we have customers that have over 200 different integrations, this is exactly what we're talking about. As we take that information and capture it with identity and consent, we take that information now, the profile, the preferences, the consent, and the account statuses, and orchestrate and govern that throughout the customer experience ecosystem and power all those digital experiences with customer data. And that's what those three products help you do. And so now that's a pretty big summary about what we've done in 2017. That is a highlight of how we bring our products to market and what those products are. And now I'd like to focus on exactly what we've accomplished in Q1. So let's take a moment now to revisit what we brought out in Q1. The first feature that I really want to highlight for you is Identity Access Studio. So some of you may have used this in the past, but what you have seen now with this new release is we have redesigned it. It is now more user-friendly with the information that you need to access here. You're able to do these individual actions on a user, on behalf of a user. It is much easier to navigate the full list of users so you can quickly search, browse, filter, get to a user, and manage those individual profiles. You're able to see who's registered, you're able to see light accounts and full accounts, and you're able to see all the information about those users. And that's really important when you think about what that central point for all of your identities are. Identity access is that central point that you want to see. Adrian, is there anything you'd like to add background-wise on identity access and talk about there?
No, first of all, hi, everyone. It's good to speak to you this afternoon or this morning. I think the main focus of identity access and the update is really based on the feedback that we got from customers that were using it actively, right? So we had some key discussions in the middle of last year, adding capabilities to the identity access, like being able to search for first name, last name, blocking an account through identity access, managing complex data as part of the account, all within the console. And this is really the first part of a larger change that's happening as part of the console. But when we go through that in a bit more detail later, I can explain a bit about what the roadmap specifically is for identity access.
Perfect. Thanks, Adrian. As we continue to think about how SAP Hybris Identity is the solution that helps you engage, we think it's important as we think about the social experience and those social logins to expand that footprint, because as we are a global society and as our customers can and do come from anywhere, we've recently added WeChat support here. So now with WeChat and Line and Kakao and Navier, we are able to cover the majority of Asia now. So WeChat has almost 1 billion unique users for their application. And then Navier and Kakao with complete support of the Korean peninsula. And as you think about all of that coverage now, you're able to reduce that friction and engage with more of your audience across the globe. And what's great about this is it also helps you leverage the out-of-the-box functionality with Gigya, but it also helps when you think about where your customers are. And it helps because you're using this out-of-the-box functionality for us to manage those connections with the social networks. And this is really exciting for us as we think about how this helps you get better with your customers. So Adrian, if you'd like to go ahead and talk a little bit about this, that would be perfect.
Yeah, and I guess this sees the organizations, our customers, yourselves, are growing in the reach that you deliver a customer experience for, right? Because WeChat being one of the largest social networks in the world, we basically released web, iOS and Android SDK support for native login to WeChat. Which was quite a rigorous process from a perspective of having those access to the development framework for that. And also our focus in South Korea on Naver and Kakao, you know, expanding into that region in further support for our social networks. It's a true sign that you know, we're delivering capabilities in that region and our customers are operating in those regions using the Gigya platform. So it's very exciting to see we expect kind of more capabilities of requirements based on the regional kind of behavior around identity as we go throughout the rest of this year and into next, specifically around identifiers and not necessarily just being about an email or a username. So we're heavily investing in kind of research into those and look forward to what we can deliver later in the year for that.
Excellent. And as we think about those regulations and those global regulations and GDPR specifically, we continue to be the leader and innovator in this space. And as we think about that regulation and being able to view all of the consent records on behalf of an individual, it's also important to be able to see from a historical perspective the individuals that have also deleted their account records. And so as we have brought this now to market, as part of the audit log, you're able to see this information here. So when you think about being audited and being keeping up with the compliance of the regulatory environments, this is an important piece where you're now able to see that information directly from the console and prove those events did indeed happen. Adrian, is there anything else you'd like to add on this piece as we talk about consent?
No, I think you covered it mainly. You know, with the likes of the regulatory requirements around the GDPR and other kind of similar regulations across the globe, you know, the onus and the kind of the proof of burden is on the organization, right? So, you know, even if a customer is requested to the right to be forgotten, you know, the ability to find the consent at a specific point of time to allow you to show in those areas of dispute that a customer either was or wasn't consented to a specific communication channel provides that extra layer of kind of assurance to you as a business that even though specific rights might be enforced that will require data to be removed, obviously you can still provide the consent status at a specific point in time.
Perfect. And as we continue to think about consent, it's really important to also be able to link to the privacy policies in terms of service. So as you think about your customer's journey and as they initially consent to those terms of service and as they have to reconsent as policies change, and as we know that those things happen over time, the GDPR requirement is really explicit about this, as it makes it easy to be able for an individual to see what text that they have consented to and have links to that information. And we continue to support that requirement with the ability to link directly to those URLs and those legal statements. So as your teams and your teams bring these new policies and have these new documents, we're able to support that use case by directly linking to those URLs as well as those legal statements. Adrian, is there something here you'd also like to add on context on this?
No, actually, I get to show everyone in a few moments, so I can talk about the detail then.
Yeah, perfect. That's right. So hopefully all of you guys are at the edge of your seat because Adrian is going to be doing a demo of identity access and these new purpose statements. So as you do have questions, please keep them coming, and we'll make sure to read those out during the demo and have Adrian show us and answer those questions. You know, as we think about SAP Hybris profile, so we've talked about identity, we've talked about consent, and we're talking a little bit about profile. Identity Sync is the solution that helps us orchestrate and govern that profile data, that consent data, the preference data, and the account data throughout that customer ecosystem. And as we think about how our clients and how you are bringing websites up, how you're developing mobile applications, it's important that we understand that part of the ecosystem, because it's important to understand how you guys are moving data between them. And so we've added the ability with Identity Sync to now copy that information and copy data between your accounts. So we're able to help as you move from a pre-production environment from a development environment to a staging environment to a pre-production environment and then ultimately to production. We're able to help. This solution helps you with that account migration, and we understand that speed to market is important as well as accuracy, and so having this solution move that data and do it in a streamlined fashion is essential to quality as well as speed to market. And with that also, Identity Sync is also able to now take the information from the audit log, determine what events are critical for what user events you want to track, assign a severity to them, and then integrate that with your SIEM or Security Information Event Management solution, those IT solutions that IT professionals love to use to monitor their infrastructure and provide those real-time alerts and security of the infrastructure. We now support that as well with Identity Sync. So you're able once again to track those events, assign severities, and push that information into your SIEM solution. Adrian, is there anything else you'd like to, you know, talk about this? As I know this was a request you and team had gotten a lot, and we're really excited to bring to market.
Yeah, no, it's good to be able to output the data that Gigya is collecting around the activity of the customer to the SIEM platforms, right? It's usually one of many different data feeds, so collating a more holistic kind of view of what's happening on from those perspectives to provide a more kind of an overview of what's happening. So, it was good to use existing technology as part of our integration platform to provide this capability. So, we're working with some key clients now on implementing this and looking forward to seeing the results.
Yeah, that's great. And as now, I think what's great is we've also continued to make other enhancements to identity consent and profile. And Adrian, if you want to just kind of run through these, and then while you're doing that, we can queue up the demo as well.
Great, sure. Yeah, obviously there's the items that we plan to work on from a strategy perspective, but also we have a very active platform and with lots of customers using it. So we often add capabilities as part of a tactical solution to help with those customer implementations. So one of the areas that's had a couple of focus areas this quarter is the ability to process both registered and unknown counts as part of an IP lockout for RBA. So not just locking out an IP address based on accounts that have been found, but also those accounts that don't exist. So expansion around the audit log, supporting customer specific messaging around an SMS template that goes out from the platform. So RBA has had a few incremental features this quarter, and I think we also plan to have a couple more over the coming quarter. Like the current plan is in the Q3 timeframe to have a ratio based lockout and a couple of other areas. So we also released at the end of last year we actually released Invisible Recapture, which is using Google's machine learning capabilities to show the recapture form as part of the registration flow, but also on the other side, you need a recapture service that is triggered from a response, so a number of login failures and things like that. So we also launched Recapture version 2 as part of the login process using our ScreenSet technology. So you can, if you use the Gigya platform and you use the ScreenSet technology today, you can enable recapture either temporarily or fully as part of the login flow. One of the areas that we continue to invest in is our SDKs and our connector support for different platforms. I think, there's been many of our integration connections that have, including the likes of Magento and WordPress and obviously Hybris, that have had updates this quarter. But we've also worked on completely rewriting our iOS SDK in Swift, which is currently being worked on with a number of our customers that have kind of been partnering with us to test and provide feedback around the Swift SDK. So the Swift SDK is another flavor of iOS, right? So it's the latest language there, and we've used the opportunity to refactor and fine tune the iOS SDK. So that's I would imagine over this quarter or early into next quarter we'll actually release that for GA, so all customers can use that. We've also done incremental updates to iOS, Android, Cordova, PHP. I would say that the Swift SDK also includes Face ID, Touch ID, and TVOS support. So exciting kind of steps forward there. We also plan to have those same capabilities as part of our Android SDK.
Awesome. You know, that is a great summary, Adrian. And I think now it's time we should probably just show everybody how this works and what this looks like. So are you ready to do that? I can stop sharing. You can start sharing and we can.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Let me know when you can see my screen.
We can. Return.
Great. Live demo. What could possibly go wrong? Let me take you through just a couple of areas of the product that we've just briefly touched on and hopefully give you a closer view of what we've been working on. So, the Gigya platform today, this is the Gigya console where you set up your configuration and your administration of both the platform and the consumers or customers as they're registering on your sites. So really, identity access with have big plans to create a more holistic kind of profile of that customer. So that you can see, what their profile is, what they're subscribed to, what their privacy settings are, what the audit log says about the changes to that account over the last year, or for the consent repository for 7 years. So all of the incremental changes to this interface we've had direct feedback from customers on. So thank you for that. So for example, this is a list of all customers on my development site. So obviously it's a lot of me. So apologies for that. But simple things like the ability to search for first name and last name. And because data in the Gigya platform is encrypted, sometimes that would cause some confusion from customers as they're searching for first name and last name because of partial matches or entering in the full field name in the first name field, for example. So some small changes there, but big impact as you're navigating the site. But also you can change things like, I only want to see people that have verified their email account, right? So that filters down the list further, and you can do things like show only light registrations, which is those customers that have only given you an email address and a consent, or fully registered customers or unregistered customers. But also, given that our platform is at its core an API system, you can also extend to custom WHERE attributes where you've got millions of customer records. And I think I was talking to a customer last week that had 76 million users as part of their platform, which is really exciting to see that this functionality is as performant with one user as it is 76 million. So really happy with that. And then as you find the set of customers that are of interest, you can then obviously drill into the details. But we've also added capabilities to the cog on the right hand side, so you can view the profile, you can copy the user ID, you can verify the email account, you can resend a verification email, reset password email, or disable login, for those customers that may have some investigation that's required or suspicious activity. You can also disable the login, which will then prevent them from logging into the platform, into your websites, into your digital properties across all of the touch points. Right. So hopefully making that easier for those administrators or those CSRs that are using the platform to manage the users. But then you can go actually into a customer record. Right. So this is my customer record. Obviously, I log in with Facebook, so you can see my profile picture and my profile fields down the right hand side here. And obviously, many of our customers have those customer attributes that are customer specific. I think, between one or two custom attributes all the way to several hundred attributes that are as part of the customer record used for the marketing technology in the front end. And again, on the left hand side here, we've added the actions menu, which can deliver those kind of reset password, all of those kind of things, deleting account, and then on the left hand side here, underneath that, we've got the profile loyalty and preferences screen, which you can manage your you know, your subscriptions to newsletters, for example, and then either opt out of the subscriptions or add tags to those subscriptions to show where the subscription was maintained. For example, if they called at the call center and opted into a newsletter, you could add that tag programmatically or through the console. So this screen is also we have a very immediate roadmap with this Identity Access Studio. Our teams are currently working on a privacy tab here. All of that data is available for the customer either through their preference centers or through the APIs or through the integration platforms. But we want to make that easier to kind of manage from a consent perspective. So thinking about the legal consent like terms of service, privacy policy, and the data processing consent like sharing my data with trusted third parties or personalizing my experience, all within the console. So you can see when they consented, what a channel they used, you know, what tags were collected as part of that and all of those kind of things. We then plan on integrating the audit log. So every change to this customer record over a year is also maintained within the platform so that you can see what's happened. And actually that audit log will be configurable actually, you know, from 6 months to 2 years of changes to an individual account record. So, those changes are on the way. We don't expect it to take as long as this first screen and the search capabilities take. So I would imagine by the end of this quarter, we'll have some further updates in this panel for our customers to use. And then the other area of the platform that I wanted to show was really around our consent management screens, because I think there's been some big updates to these screens over the course of Q1. So our consent product is part of SAP Hybris Consent, and this is our enterprise preference management solution. But I wanted to show you a bit of what goes on in the back here to manage your preferences and your consent objects, right? So almost every site that you engage with as part of exchanging data, you have that terms of service, which is managed up here, your privacy policy, and then other consent statements, which is like your data processing for personalization, sharing with third party, you know, maybe using the data to fill in your profile and things like that. So these could be one, or they could be many, or they could be hundreds of different data processing consents that can be issued to your web technology. And the benefit of the Gigya platform being in place is that if you have 100 websites and your terms of service changes, rather than changing all of those websites, you change it centrally here, and then everyone will be asked to re-consent to the latest version, or if it's a minor version, just newly registered users will start to collect that version of consent. And to show you an example of what we've been working on this quarter, we've actually added, so for example, you can add effective dates or, you know, effective as of a version number or a date. So you can have your versioning of the consent based on version number or date, but also you can add the purpose and the document URL as part of the consent template. Right. So using all of the languages that we support today in the Gigya platform, for example, if I wanted a Dutch purpose, I would write in Dutch the purpose text here, which is really the text next to the checkbox as part of a consent collection. And then the document URL, it might be the document where I have an offline version or a printable version of that terms of service, because the reality is today that if I signed up for a terms of service that's a year old, I still need access to that terms of service, right? So the customers that we're working with are changing those terms of service approach to content and having version specifics so that those that provided consent 2 years ago can still see the document that they subscribed to at that point. So this all is integrated into our screen sets. So you drag the widget onto the screen sets, and based on the language of the customer, it will show the right purpose. But then this purpose and this document URL is also stored in our audit log. So every consent change, which includes withdrawals, renewals, grants, all of those actions are stored in the Gigya platform for 7 years. So any one of those changes, along with this purpose, can be audited for that 7-year period, really providing a framework of the capability to prove the level of consent at a specific time within your ecosystem. And so that's it from a demo perspective. That was as brave as I was going to be with the live demo. So going to stop sharing my screen and then hand back to Ritul.
All right. Thanks, Adrian. That's great. Which brings us now, after the demo, right into questions and answers. So, Adrian, how would you like me to handle this? Should I just go oldest to newest and read them off to you, and you can kind of go through them?
Yeah, I've been trying to answer some of the questions. I think one of the common questions that came in when you were talking, Ratul, was where can we get more detail on the products offered as part of the Gigya solution, solutions from Gigya. So maybe that's a relevant one for you as well.
Yeah, absolutely. So where do you get new information about the three products and where they are? And what's great about that is the hybris.com website is actually broken out into those three products. We have not updated gigya.com yet. However, we do have blogs on our gigya.com website that do talk about the three products and how they're broken out, as well as the hybris.com website does have the solution overview and a per product data sheet, or information sheet as SAP calls it, that outline what each of the three products power and solve. So we have four unique pieces of collateral and lots of web pages out there as well. And I believe the developer documentation also has key information about how those three products are outlined as well.
Great. Okay. So maybe it would help if I went through the list. Some of these I can answer. Some I need further time to answer, because they're quite complex responses. So I guess one of the questions was, is consent management available for light accounts? And yes, it is. So the reason that actually that was an evolution based on the end of last year, if you're even collecting what we call light accounts, so just an email or a profile, then you still need to collect, say, the privacy acceptance of consent or the terms of service. So yes, that is supported today, and something that we modified actually in Q1. One of the other questions was, is the recapture feature available for light registrations? Actually, that's something that we plan to work on either later on in this Q2 timeframe or early into Q3. That was one of the items that we plan to add to those capabilities. I'm just looking through.
Yeah, there was another question that I can answer is, will this information be made available to everyone after this? The session, and absolutely, the presentation, the recording will be posted to gigya.com, and we're going to have a recap blog as well, summarizing this for those who were not able to attend, and all that information will definitely be made available and sent out to both attendees and those who have missed the webinar.
Great. Okay. So one of the other questions was, when do you think you'll integrate with finger login for mobile device? Obviously, that's supported today as an iOS with the Touch ID. We are actually working with our Android SDK team to see if we can get feature parity there. That should be something that we're working on over the next few months, and I think the expectation is, and our hope is, that we'll have biometric login on both mobile SDKs going forward. So that's one thing. There was a question around what we expect to deliver over the next few quarters. And just at a high level, we're working on an extensibility platform at the moment, which is integrating into our existing platform. So within the login workflow, within the registration workflow, within the profile management workflow, you will be able to hook into those flows and do things like data quality techniques and call out to another API somewhere that triggers an action, like provisioning an account in the CRM or something like that. We're actually live with that as like an internal kind of test as part of password validation, and that's really our immediate kind of focus. One of the other things that we plan to work on this year is adding the Google Authenticator as a second factor of authentication to two-factor authentication. And then there's a whole host of consent features that we're currently working on, which is including preference centers for light accounts, really making those more accessible and easy to create in as part of a screen set rather than the solutions that we have today, which are great, but we want to make it easier to do those things.
Yeah, there's a lot of questions about WeChat and mobile number support, Adrian, if that's something you'd like to briefly touch on before we get into the future looking, what we're going to be doing.
Yeah, so the first thing was that we wanted to come out with our WeChat integration because actually most of those customers in, say, China, for example, that may not use or prefer to use an email address or don't have access to an email address will either use something like WeChat or set up an account so that they're using, say, mobile phone as a login identifier. And I would say that we have a solution today using with a couple of our customers, our global customers, using a solution today for phone number as a login identifier. But we do want to make that much more out of the box. So it was something that we plan to do in the Q4 timeframe this year to have a fully supported kind of phone number as a login identifier. But we're still evaluating that based on what the solution we have today and the gap between that and a fully kind of delivered product version. So it's something that we're definitely thinking about. It's high in my mind of things that I'm thinking about.
We've also got two questions related to B2B scenarios. How does that work with Hybris Commerce, as well as how do we, Gigya, support the account hierarchy in the context of B2Bs with administrators and users and roles and permissions? So if you'd like to talk about the B2B scenario, that'd be great.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. I also saw a note about why do you store data for 7 years and not five or 10? And that's because actually we evaluated the regional kind of legislation and the highest requirement of storing data was 6 years. So we chose to go for seven. So it wasn't just a random, we weren't playing darts in the office and just picked that number, but it's a great question. So thank you for that. In regards to B2B, it's actually highly relevant because it's something that we're evaluating at the moment. We do have plans to more fully integrate into solutions that power the B2B solution, probably in the beyond the half year point. So we are actually going to partner or we are currently working with a partner on an integration for our access control solution, which includes account hierarchy and entitlements and groupings and roles and those kind of capabilities around access control, about the decision making of who has access to what and what are their entitlements. So we are planning some work there. Ultimately, we want to deliver grouping and say the model of a business partner inside the platform. That's a longer term strategy, but something that we plan to do. I wouldn't say that's immediate because it's a quite big change, but it's definitely something that we're planning and we see the value of. So for lightweight grouping, like parenting, we have a few customers live with a solution using grouping within the account objects, which is working well. But they quickly become complex, and that's where you need some level of organizational structure or access control as part of those solutions. So that's what we're planning to kind of first of all thinking about partnering and then working on building those into the Gigya platform.
Thank you, Adrian. That's perfect. And I think now is a great opportunity to pause for a moment and thank our customers for attending and joining us. And we wouldn't be able to do all of the fun things we do, all the great innovations that we work on, if it wasn't for you. And so we greatly appreciate you joining this webinar.